First of all, the temperature on Earth is determined by the amount of energy that we receive from the sun. The sun is the sole source of energy required for life on Earth. And as I mentioned before, the trajectory of the Earth around the sun is nearly circular. There is a deviation of a few percent, so that the seasons, which are characterized by different temperatures, summers are hotter than winters, could not be related to the change in the distance between the Earth and the sun, because that distance is practically always the same. The reason for the seasons is that the Earth's rotational axis is tipped relative to the perpendicular to its orbital plane. So, for instance, in June, the North Pole is tipped more strongly towards the sun, so that at that time, the northern hemisphere receives more direct sunlight than the southern hemisphere. And as a result, the temperatures in the northern hemisphere go up and are higher during the summer. In December, we have the opposite situation. The North Pole of the Earth, because it turns out that the Earth's rotational axis keep approximately the same direction in space. So as the Earth revolves around the sun, the direction of the spin axis is always the same. As a result, in June, the North Pole, or the northern hemisphere, is tipped more towards the sun than the southern hemisphere. And as a result, it receives more direct solar heating, as illustrated here. So for instance, in the summer, the sunlight falls more directly on the northern hemisphere. There is more energy per unit area in the northern hemisphere than in the southern hemisphere, where that same amount of energy is spread over the larger area. In December, we have the opposite situation. Then the northern hemisphere is tipped most strongly away from the sun, in which case the things are reversed. The northern hemisphere receives less direct solar heating than the southern hemisphere, and we have winter in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. Okay? If there was no tilt of the Earth's rotational axis relative to the vertical on the Earth orbital plane, then we would have no seasons. Okay? And it's surprising that is not generally appreciated. I remember watching years ago a program, I forget now which part of the science program it was, where they interviewed the graduating class from Harvard University, which is considered as one of the best schools in the world, if not the world, certainly in North America. Okay? And they were asking the graduates the question, why do we have seasons? What is the reason? And nearly all of them were saying that we have seasons because in December and January, we are farther away from the sun and therefore receive a less solar heating than in June, where we are closer to the sun. In fact, it's the opposite. Turns out that right now, the Earth is closest to the Sun in actually in January, not by much, because the distance varies only by at most 2%. And we are at the greatest distance from the Sun actually on 4th of July, on Independence Day in US. Okay? So all of them said that we have seasons because the distance between the Earth and the Sun changes. That is not true. The reason that we have seasons is that the Earth's rotational axis is tipped so that part of the year the northern hemisphere receives more solar heating, and 6 months later it receives less.